Welcome to SNL Adventures in Food, and we're back again with another food review, and we're at Round Table Pizza Vatos. So, why starving? I'm starving. So, what do we have? We got the King Arthur's Supreme Pizza. It has everything, Vato, everything from salami, pepperoni, sausage, bell peppers, onions, todo, Vato, todo, everything. And we got, you guys know how we roll, plain wings. We don't like all that spicy buffalo crap and blue cheese. And the wife got ranch. My mama. So, yeah, we're bringing you guys a review. So, enjoy it, Vato.
With music.
With cholo music, eh? We're in the barrio, you know, so they're bumping the oldies, eh?
What time is it?
It's late.
It's gonna be
3. It's 3 p.m. and this is our breakfast.
Yeah, we haven't eaten
nothing. Ain't that a biscuit? But we're out running around, running errands. We're supposed to go to Disneyland today. We're tired. Yes,
Charlie.
No, tell
them what happened in the morning.
What happened?
Where are we gonna go? Like about 7:30. We used the restroom and we just got back in bed and we felt like we're supposed to go just one.
We still could have gone because Disneyland closes at 11. But yesterday I was being Mr. Gardner again at the other house and I woke up sore. Like my abuelita used to wake up after my abuelito got done with her in the night, you know? But if we would have been at Disneyland, it would have been horrible walking back.
Well, yeah, I guess. And I helped him with the yard too, so.
I was cutting a tree.
You know, we're getting
cleaning,
old.
Cleaning gutters.
No, he was cleaning the gutters of the house.
I was doing everything, eh?
Yeah, horrible. Because you know the rain's coming. Like, we get a lot of rain.
Pómale, homie, la pinche pizza era tan buena. Chinga su madre. I'm dropping all my toppings, fool.
But no, yeah, he had to get up on the roof and trim that tree. Mm. There's so much to do. Every time we go there, we come home so fucking tired. It's a long, cold off season. And I'm tired, like, fuck, man.
But college football is back. So we had a lot of errands to run. So I told the wife, you know what, let's just stay home and do what we got.
Yeah, because it's already 10 or something. And I'm going to Disneyland. And I was hoping he would say no. He was like, no. I was like, okay, I don't care.
But I went to the feed store, got feed for all the animals, mm-hmm. while the wife was getting ready, you know. Hey, we're gonna get copywritten, and I don't care. It just shows you about those that we don't do this to get paid. We're just doing it to bring you guys reviews, and you guys enjoy the food, you know.
Plus, Sergio likes to talk. He was talking already so early this morning. I'm not gonna lie, you guys. I told him, babe, shut up. Like, I don't want to conversate early.
Some pepper flakes for the pizza.
Okay.
Yeah. Well rested.
I always come warma. I talk too much.
Pues ya, I'm Pepe Barreto. If you guys don't know who Pepe Barreto, Google it, fool. But if you guys never been a Round Table Pizza, Vato, that's bomb. This pizza already has toppings on top of toppings.
It's so good, guys. I love it.
And the wings for the blue cheese, watch out. Oh my, homie.
But yeah. And today's my day off.
Today's your day off. And yeah. My day off. I don't got no days off because I've been posting videos every day.
Yeah.
So I got no days off.
But no, I just went back to work on my day. I already have a day off. Because
these are
my days off.
You know, the chusma go ahead and they talk shit. Hey, you're a loser. You don't got a job, fool. YouTube's a job, fool. I gotta record stuff. I gotta edit shit. I gotta upload shit. You know what I mean? But they just think it's easy. It's
I not, don't do any of that.
It's not hard.
I just chill.
I'm not gonna say it's hard, but I'm not gonna say it's easy. It's in the middle, fool, like medium, man.
It is time consuming.
What? We came in. They got the oldies bumped in. They're like, well, tell them to shut it down. Okay, let it roll. It's good. It's nice music, you know? It's not
bad. Well, we don't listen to this music.
No, because we get up for a deal. Like, baby, come here, hug me. The wife said she was in the restroom. She's thinking, oh, I want to go dance with my husband. Didn't you say that?
No, I didn't say it. I said, man, this music. I think I'm going to go out there and go dance with them. It makes me feel like I want to go dance.
What did I just say?
And right here, we have salad. The salad we were eating.
You guys seen in the intro, I showed all the food. Oh. Salad, we ate it while we waited. Ate it while we waited. I mean, around. And it's cool. All the setup here, watch out. They put the pizza on the second floor while you're on the first floor, fool.
Look at that. Oh my god, there's so much goodness right here. That's just...
This place right now, it's not dead, but it's not full. Obviously, people are at work. But we like it. This is our second time being here, and it's cool. It's relaxing here.
And you guys, Sergio loves olives.
I do.
So we get olives on. Well,
what?
I don't even think you. I was gonna say something about a review that you did, and I'm not gonna say it. So I don't think you posted that.
Yeah. Well, if they're watching this, they already watched it. That's how far in advance I am. If you guys are watching this, you guys watch my spaghetti review. So there's black olives in there and mushrooms.
Yeah.
So yeah.
He loves olives, like he loves olives in spaghetti.
I do.
So if you've seen it already with chicken. Go ahead, baby.
The wife hasn't even seen the spaghetti review because it's getting posted today.
Yeah.
It's getting posted tomorrow. That's why she didn't want to say nothing.
I know,
but
I gotta, okay, whatever. But anyways, I get chicken for him because he loves chicken. I won't eat it. That's too much. That's just too much protein for me.
Because spaghetti is a side dish for me.
You guys, okay, I make him the spaghetti, which, okay, it has the ground beef. Usually I put sausage and meatballs and all that, but I'm too tired when I come home from work, so I made it real quick. But he wants chicken on the side, because that's the main dish. The chicken, you said?
Yeah.
Or the side dish?
The spaghetti is a side dish. Comment below, let me know. Spaghetti is a side dish for me. Because I'm fat.
Comment below what? If it's a side dish?
Yeah.
Spaghetti's not a side dish.
Well, that's what I'm asking. Comment below if you guys say it's a side dish or is it? Well, it's a full course meal. To me, it's not.
Course, babe.
Not for me. So, that's what I'm asking them. To comment below.
Look at
she's getting all prendida. Relax, baby. He's touching me under the table, eh? Careful there, eh?
Wow. I used to listen
to this when I was like 20. This is the music. The cholos bump in, they're driving, and they go slower, eh? Like, gotta honk at those. I'm sorry, fool, I was driving with the music, you know? And then they lean like this.
But we understand.
Yeah, because I used to do it on my bicycle, eh? So I fell off and shit, and then, you know, I didn't wear no helmet.
Babe, we're gonna get into story time right now.
What?
When you fell off your bike.
I fell off my bike.
How old were you?
About 18.
What happened? Tell us. I love when you tell
stories. I was coming. But check it out. Here's the work at. At Dryer's Ice Cream in Walnut off Bread Canyon Road, and I didn't have a ranfla for it. it didn't close my eyes and I got a car issue, you know? I don't work that way. So I had a bicycle up, and the job was through an agency, and I would go in 3, 4, 5 p.m. in the afternoon. So I'll take the bus to work, Bato, but with my bike. So I'll wait for the bus. You put your bike on the front rack. First time ever putting my bike on the front rack. Almost fell off, and then we ran it over, Bato.
Because he didn't even tell you, huh?
No,
like, somebody's bike's gonna fall.
Yeah, the Bato gets the microphone. Whoever's little bike is about to fall. Well, fuck, fool. Tell me how to strap it down. It has a strap that goes on the front wheel. I don't know.
And how many bikes do people have at the front? So just was the only one.
Yeah, mine was the only one. And obviously the driver's at the window watching you. If you see me, I didn't strap it down. How come I say shit? Because he wanted to run my bike over, right?
Yeah, baby wants to run your bike
so
over.
He had to pull the, bus over. People are looking at me like, hey, stupid, we're going to be late because you don't strap your bike down, you know? So it was embarrassing. I felt like just grabbed my bike and fucking jump on it and say, fuck the bus, you know? But I didn't. Strapped it down, jumped on the bus. Went to work. Like, when the bus would leave me, I still had to travel on the bike. So sad but true, but I would get out at 2, 3 in the morning. The buses weren't running yet. So I would ride the bike home. That's far from Walnut to work, to the pad. So I got my backpack on, have a little boom box, you know, a cassette player back in the day, you know, listening to this fucking music and shit, ain't that was badass, you know, and I'm rolling on the bike in chinga, and I cut through Old Town Puente, if you guys are familiar, all you know, and I cut through, and I thought I was a badass when I backpack like that in chinga, no hands, you know, I thought I was fucking one of those marathon fucking bicyclists. I hit an uneven pavement and the steering wheel to my car because it was a bicycle fool. The handlebars are going like this. So I tried to reach for it. No, that thing, next thing you know, the bike slipped. I was on the floor fucking rolling. No lie. I landed here and the bike ended up in the intersection because it was early in the morning. There was nobody there, fool. It was a stop sign intersection. I got up. like Chapulín Colorado, I jumped up, boom, and dusted myself off. And the first thing, reaction, anybody's reaction when you fall, who's seen me? There was nobody. And after I did that, I said, oh, fuck, you know, the pain kicks in, you know, because you gotta be macho, man, you know, I'm okay, you know, but my fucking bone was sticking out, you know, but I'm okay. No, there was no bone sticking out, but I've seen shit like that. Got up, picked up my bike. The chain was fucked up, my brakes were fucked up. I couldn't ride it no more, Bato. I couldn't ride it no more.
So how did you take it home?
I fucked up my wrist. This shit was all swollen like that. It looked like my abuelita's legs, eh, you know? All puffy and shit, eh? Because I don't got good more, no more good. What's it called? My blood don't flow that good no more, mijo. So it was all like that, hinchado, eh? Swollen. So I'm walking with the bike, you know, fucking in pain. Like, fuck it, I gotta walk home now, you know? I was halfway there. And I'm walking, a fucking cop shows up, goes, hey, what are you doing? What does it look like, stupid? Walking home. Where are you coming from? Work. Well, how come you're not riding your bike? Because I just fell. Well, won't you stop? I need to talk to you. Like, what the fuck? He stops, whatever. He puts my bike up against his car, and then he grabs my hand. The one that's all swollen. What the fuck? He starts searching me, and dude, I said, I just fucking fell off the fucking bike. He twisted my arm. And then he looked at the bike that was all fucked up. He starts laughing. He goes, all right, I'm sorry, man. It just looks suspicious out here early in the morning. Motherfucker, I just got off of work, fool. You know? But that's what the wife was like, laughing about. I got stories for days, Bato. You know? But yeah, that was a bicycle.
It really does, you guys.
And since my arm was fucked up, I couldn't go back to work. So, I didn't get fired, because back in the day, I don't know how it is now, but you call the agency and, hey, you know what? I don't want to do ice cream. Tomorrow, I want to be an astronaut, you know, or I want to work for who knows. And you have another job the next day. That's how I was. So I called them, hey, my hands fucked up. I used to load the ice cream trucks, eh? But not the ones that pass by on the hood, fool. The ice cream trucks that go to the stores, eh? And, yeah, I didn't have a job. So I chilled to my fucking, but also went back to normal because I didn't have medical insurance for either, so I was fucked, you know? And after that, I don't remember what job I got. I fucking worked all the warehouses and shit.
You got another bike or what?
I fixed it. You know how I fixed it? The chain was easy. Put the chain back on. Tying it, boom. The brakes, they're broken. So I just took the motherfuckers off. And I used to use my shoe to stop after. Once Zapata was out wasted, I used to walk all uneven and shit.
Discover deals and find your fashion at
the wife took off. She don't want to pay the bill.
Jeans and fresh washes, flattering rises, and
that's the story. All the bicicleta.
Joggers, fleece, add a boot to the bag, and pop off your cart
but,
with a jacket in fall
friendly
suede and denim. Spend less on
today is Thursday,
bato. Head to Burlington.com or tap the banner to find your store
today. Today the Dodgers play, so it's winter, go home, bato, so I can't wait to go home and get ready to watch the Dodger game, bato. You scared me.
Why?
I thought you took out because you don't want to pay the bill. Yeah, I hear you gotta pay in front, Mato. You can't eat and leave.
I think it's kind of pricey here. Well, I don't know how much.
Well, she didn't pay, but she it's pricey. It's a medium pizza, 12 wings, 2 sodas, and a salad. $60, Mato.
16?
60. 16. Take me to a place where you can eat for $16. Little Caesars.
$60?
See, $60. So don't ever say, I don't love you, Wayne.
He just went to the buy feed for all the animals, and he said he spent...
$90.
$90? I was like, what the... Why? Well, I shouldn't say why. They have a lot of animals. And that's not even including Dodgers food. Dodgers food is...
$60.
Exactly. Oh, that little booger.
For a 30-pound bag. It's not even a 50-pound, a 40-pound. 30 pounds, $60.
And his food stinks, you guys. You guys will gag. I can't smell that stuff. It's
I don't know sometimes if it's the food or my abuelita. Like, which is it, eh? But Dodger loves the food.
He does.
That's just making him look like Popeye. There's nothing but protein and vitamins in that food. All the dog breeders out there, they know what's up. The Victor's dog food. It's expensive, but worth it for your puppy, your dogs, because motherfucker look like the Incredible Hulk and shit.
Awesome, you guys.
Huh?
It's so fucking cute.
Look at that shit. It's a salami thing. Big old rueda.
I'm done. But, not really done.
You're done? You still got a whole pizza. And the wife goes, it's only 8 slices. Well, yeah, mama. How big do you want the pizza?
You guys, he eats a lot.
I thought I talked a lot.
But before this, we went everywhere. Anyways, before this, we went to Target. Before Target, we went to somewhere else. But anyways, I wanted to show you.
La tienda de la abuelita, fool.
If you.
I'm eating. Show it, mama. Sure. So don't be shy.
I got this at Target. It's a little cupcake. Just dessert. It's called vegan.
Is that the one you
put in? Chocolate midnight cupcake. Nut-free bakery.
Is that the one you just put in your purse?
Yep.
She walked out, she didn't pay
no,
for it.
I didn't.
She said, yup.
No. No, babe. We did pay for it.
Oh.
We did pay for it. Yep. We paid for it, and then I put it in my purse when we came in here.
The wife brings her own dessert. What's next? Your own soda?
Either that or buy a dessert here. And
oh, shit. We would pay like $100. So it's a vegan?
Yeah, it's vegan.
It's vegan.
I can't open it though.
And you hear the female rollers in the background, eh, you know?
Look at you guys.
Put a pepperoni on it.
Take a bite, guys.
I'm putting pepperoni.
Anyways, Target, guys, they have like, flavors. Oh, we bought, we were going to Target to buy the Pepperidge Farm cookies. They said that online that they had some for the pumpkin ones.
We can't go to any store to buy one shit. We went to the market to buy tortillas, and we came out with fucking $60 worth of fucking groceries and beer and pisco.
Yeah, we bought beer.
Micheladas and la chinga.
Because we were passing by, he goes, do you want to go into this aisle? And it's just beer with chips,
well,
that's all.
Well, Northgate Market, they always have different types of beers. It's a paisa store, but they have a variety of beers. And it proved it. The wife walked out with a mouth bag, eh? And she goes, and then she told me,
Look at that goodness, guys. Vegan, guys.
When we got here, she heard the oldie. She goes, fool, go get the 12-pack. We can kick back and drink this stuff right here.
Oh, we should have. You guys, we bought Bud Light. What is it? Bud Light what?
Micheladas.
And micheladas. Different flavors, huh?
Yeah, it's a 12-pack.
This is what it looks like, guys. I'll save you a piece of it, okay?
Nah, I'm good. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, it's Fia. It's almost Virgil's birthday. I'm so excited.
I don't remember my birthday, boo. Pero, the wings are bomb. Hello.
And he still looks good for his age.
I don't have a quinceañera, eh?
The quinceañero.
Ni de las navidas.
This is so good. It's not even frozen, like whipped.
Frosty the snowman?
This is good.
Watch out, my chicken wing has pelo, eh?
Oh yeah, you know what? I wanna go try. Joe went to a
Krispy Kreme donuts.
Yeah, what is it? The Halloween.
It's like a Halloween box with a variety of donuts.
I seen them.
They have all kinds of sugar frosting, like chingada.
Yeah, he posted on Instagram. He's like a little snack. He's always eating little snacks. He's another one where he eats a lot, and he's like, oh, I'm just having a little snack.
That's the homie Joe. I'm gonna bring the vato on the episode because he's a homie, you know? So, hey, Joe, I know you're watching. We gotta set a date. And do an episode, even here, fool. Look, we got pizza, wings, whatever. Let me know.
Okay, guys. This is really good. But the frosting is really, really sweet. But I guess it blends in well then when you eat it with this. You can't have this.
I don't want it. But why is the dessert freak? I'm not.
Oh, yeah.
Jeez, se acabaron las rolas. Let's go put another quarter in the jukebox.
I'm too lazy, darling. He ordered dessert and he ate it all.
Now that was bomb. I'm gonna go put a quarter in the jukebox. Se acabó las rolas.
So sweet.
After we got copyrighted, the music turned on. It's fucked up, man. But this shit is bomb.
I'll take this half home to Dad. He likes sweets.
This is my second time having round table pizza in his bar. Huh. We always get the one with everything because that's what we like, huh? Has the linguine. The little mini pepperoni thing. I think that's what it's called.
It's linguine, babe.
Is it? I told you it has something to do with weenie in it. Linguine.
So you guys, here we go with another story. I have a little dog. At our house over there, the ranch in Riverside. She's a pure white chihuahua. I'm not sure if I posted her, but I will.
She's cute. She looks like a, let me describe her. A fat little white lab rat without the tail. Huh. That's what she reminds me of.
She's all white, like all white, pretty white. Maybe with a little bit of brown, but I don't know, it's weird. And her eyes are black. Anyways, her name's Wendy. Who named her Wendy? I think Isaac, my kids did. Isaac and Paco named her Wendy. Well, when my grandfather passed away, then we moved with my grandma to take care of her. And she was like, oh, I like your dog. And oh, she's pretty. And they said, what's her name? And I'm like, her name's Wendy. And she's like, okay. I go, Wendy. She goes, oh, I can't say that. She said it in Spanish. She's like, I can't say that. I said, say it. And I helped her. I was like, Wendy. She goes, Winnie. I said, no, not Winnie. And I go, Wendy. And she goes, Winnie? I go, no, no, Winnie, no, Winnie. And I explained what a Winnie was. I said, Ma, you don't want to call her that. And she was like, Winnie? And so anyways, so now we call her
Winnie. Well, if that would say that, it's because she wanted Winnie.
I got to take this phone call.
Oh, let me continue the story. She wanted. The grandma called her Weenie, so the dog's name stood as Weenie. And it's crazy because she's an indoor dog, and we let her out the front yard. And, excuse me, sometimes it's time for the dog to come in, the neighbors are out. I'm not gonna go out there and say, hey, weenie, come in. They're gonna think like, este wey quiere weenie to come in. Chale, fool. But that's the story of her dog, Weenie. And I believe the wife got a phone call from the brother-in-law. Just an update, he's still in ICU. And I think his condition is stable, but he's still on oxygen and he has a long way for recovery. So just an update. I know some of you guys asked and appreciate it and thank you guys. But yeah, this is our Roundtable Pizza review. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Enjoyed the soundtrack. You know, they shut it off now after we got copyrighted, but it's all good. I want to bring you guys a review and keep in touch, you know what I mean? But before we go, you guys know the drill. Hit the like button, comment below, share the channel, and subscribe. And all the new subscribers, hey, hopefully you guys are enjoying this review, you know? And hit the thumbs up, I told you, know, like the little grandkids say, hit the thumbs up, fool, you know, and subscribe. But that's all I have for you guys. So until then, you guys have a wonderful day.